How to use Pathfinder in Adobe Illustrator.
Hey guys, Kerry Hawkins here with another VectorMade.com tutorial. In today's tutorial, we're going to be discussing how to use Pathfinder options in Adobe Illustrator. Now, if you don't see that on your layout, just go up here to Window and click on Pathfinder, and it should show up somewhere over here to the right, and you'll see all these icons. We're going to go through each one of these and discuss what they do. So let's jump on in. The first option under Pathfinder Shape Modes is Unite. So if we overlap these two and select both of them and then click Unite, you'll see that it creates one shape out of the two using the color from the front shape. The second option under Shape Modes is Minus Front. So if I drag this over, select both, and click this, you'll see that the front object is taken away from the back object, creating somewhat of a crescent moon shape. The third option under Shape Modes is Intersect. Now this one will do the same thing. Drag it over here, select both, and click Intersect. And it's just gonna leave the area that was intersecting on both shapes. It will take on the color properties of the top object. The fourth option is Exclude. That will do the opposite effect of Intersect. So if we get both of these together and click Exclude, now all of a sudden it's going to take out the area where they intersect, and of course, leaving you with the color of the top object. Jumping down to Pathfinders, the first option is Divide. Now I'll bring these shapes together, select them both, click on Divide, and it's not quite apparent what's happened yet. You have to right-click and hit Ungroup. Now you will be able to freely drag each piece that was cut out. So I find that this one's the most useful. For instance, if I want to, I can delete this middle section, and it's similar to if we did exclude. However, I get to keep the original colors of both shapes. The second option under Pathfinders is Trim. So if we take the objects, grab them, click Trim, it's going to erase the overlap from the top object from the back object. Now, if I right click and hit Ungroup and then drag this out, you should be able to see that. The third option is Merge. Now, if I take this over and I click Merge, it's going to look exactly the same as it did with Trim. If they are the same color, however, and I do this, it's going to look the same as Unite. So why do they have the Merge option? Well, let's throw in a third circle. I'll throw in a second blue circle. And here we have three. They're all overlapping. If I grab all three and then I click Merge, it's going to combine the two blue circles and cut them out from the red circle. So if I hit Ungroup and drag that away, you'll see the difference. The fourth option is Crop, and that is going to crop the back object with the front object, like so. The fifth option is Outline, and so if I grab those two together, click Outline, you will see that it creates outlines of everything. I'm going to go ahead and bump this up to 20 so you can see what's going on. If I ungroup these, you'll see I have individual line segments that are created. The sixth option is Minus Back, and it does exactly what you think it does. It takes the back from the front, like so. If you liked that tutorial, please leave a comment down below and smash the like button. Also, check out some of my other tutorials right over here, and I will see you in the next video.